Do you think because there's this problem where laws and regulations can't keep up with technology, should we look at, you know, to other jurisdictions that seem to be doing a better job, like the European Union, with their directives, you know, that are released? You know, should we look at some of these progressive ways dealing with the issues?
I think the United States has to look at other jurisdictions to learn. For instance, in the European Union, now 25 countries, and a very interesting collection of countries with different viewpoints on law and intellectual property, and how you make money, how authors are compensated. I mean, Europe is where, the European Union, where moral rights began. I mean, there are so many progressive things that happen in other countries, the European Union, and closer. I love Canada. I love the experiments. I think they're experiments that Canada tries. How they deal with some of these same issues can be very enlightening to us. There are things, I was with David Baskin just a couple weeks ago, and he's the president of the CMRRA in Canada, and they're the ones who are concerned with mechanical royalties for music and Canadian music. And what they do in Canada, they have decided that all these things have value, the performance of music. If you bought a blank CD and you're going to fill it with something, it would be of value. Your act of filling that CD with music would be of value. We don't do things because they have no value, so there's value. So the Canadian government has imposed a levy, and if you call it a tax, they'll flip out at you and say, it's not a tax. Mm-hmm. A tax goes to the government. Levy goes to the creators. I said, that is a good point. So they have a levy. If you bought 100 blank CDs, I think it's $21 extra it will cost you on that 100 blank CDs. So I think I bought 100 recently for about $30 or $34. So suddenly, if I was in Toronto buying that same pack of 100, instead of it costing me 30, it would cost me 51. Of course, I don't like to pay more. I'd rather pay 30 than 51. But if that's how it goes, and if that money is really being used as a levy because it's going to compensate artists and creatives for what they have done and what I'm taking advantage of, I think that's a good idea. I know it kind of hurts. It's a it's extra money, but it's a levy and not a tax, which I buy that. And that's one example of something that could be tried. And that might be kind of steep, and I do think it can be steep. I've read the estimates that some iPods could end up costing $50 to $70 more, which I understand because there's a lot of stuff in there. It's a one-time fee. Mm-hmm. Okay, I get it. But some other things in Canada, whether I don't know how well it's stated, but I go to Canada a lot. I stay in hotels in Ottawa, Montreal, Vancouver, Toronto, Quebec, mm-hmm. and there's a contract, often referred to in this country as an end-user license agreement. So I go in, I want to get broadband in my room, and I always copy that silly contract. You know, you usually say, I agree, but I'm nerdy enough and I like law enough that I go read them. So and they're usually only 300 words, where Apple EULAs, end user license agreements for the iPod, they're about 4,500 words. And I don't read every word there, because I just don't want to. But these 300 words, I thought, this is nice. So I read it, and it said, I cannot transmit. It kept saying, I can't transmit material, copyrighted material, and so forth. And I'd heard about this and read some things, that in Canada, it's legal to download music, to take music from the internet, from peer-to-peer networks. It's legal, L-E-G-A-L, to download music. But illegal to upload it. Now, of course, that reminds me of the policy on gay men and women in the military, don't ask, don't tell. Mm-hmm. I thought, what is this? It's kind of nebulous. And I read I always read my contracts in the hotels, and they say I cannot transmit. It never uses the word download. It doesn't say receive. It doesn't say all these other things, which led me to believe that, wait a minute, they're careful about what they spell out. These are lawyers writing this stuff. And it made it very clear that the other things I'd been reading had said you can't upload to the internet, but you can download. And, you know, because I guess that sounds to me like someone's being practical and saying, well, we know it's happening. So maybe they can try to compensate and find revenues, levies. Why can't peer-to-peer why can't these things work this way? Get a license issued mm-hmm. That you can collect money. Why can't it be that you pay on how much electricity you use, how much water, how much broadband you use? There have to be some more creative ways of doing it than suing people and hoping they'll stop, because that's just not happening. It's futile.
Does that please the RIAA and the Canadian market?
The RIAA and the Canadian version, which is really weak compared to ours, the CRIA, they hate that. They think this is just awful. But what I look at, what's the alternative? This is behavior. This is what people do. And they're going to keep doing it, and of course it can make more money. If we didn't have an iPod and a digital market, that would hurt now. It's now starting to become sizable revenue. It's not 50%. It could be anywhere from 10 to 15 to 20 to 30%. It's growing. Digital world is growing. We need to take advantage of it. What the RIAA instead are doing with these foolish lawsuits against 400 individuals a month, it's about 400 they sue. To me, I view that as someone who leaves a men's room with toilet paper on their shoe. I mean, are you proud of what you've done? You look foolish. You know, this just looks dumb. It didn't amount to anything. You're embarrassing yourself. Stop doing it. Employing lawyers is not always the best thing to do. It's just frivolous and stupid what they're doing.